Welcome to Tantrum House at CMON Expo. I'm Melissa Delp, and I'm here with Shawn, and we're looking at a prototype of Blue Moon City by Reiner Knizia.
Yeah, so this is Blue Moon City, and it is a city that has been ravaged from years of wars, and the wars have ended, but they have to rebuild the city. So you're controlling a faction which is going to move around the city and sort of almost semi-cooperatively work with other factions to rebuild some of the different buildings. And so on a turn, simply, you're going to move your faction marker around the city, and then if you're able to, you'll discard cards that are equal to the color and power level of the building that you're trying to rebuild. And once all of the different sections of the building have been rebuilt, all of a sudden we flip it over to its rebuilt side, and there's going to be bonuses for everybody who's contributed, but a special bonus for the person who's contributed the most. And you're going to get the bonus for the city itself, but then also other cities around it, you'll get a district bonus, anything orthogonally adjacent to it that has also been rebuilt. So it's like you're beautifying that particular neighborhood. And everything that you're doing throughout this game is in the goal to get crystals. Because as you get more and more crystals throughout the course of the game, you're going to be able to contribute to the ultimate goal of the city. So Blue Moon City, one of the symbols of their strength and wealth is the Citadel, which sits in the middle of the city. And so you'll be able to, throughout the course of the game, contribute by discarding crystals to add to the Citadel itself. And depending on the player count, that's going to determine how many of your own contribution tokens are needed to win the game. But everything comes down to the Citadel itself. Yeah. So very interesting one. A lot of the actions that are done throughout the game are driven by the cards, and they're different people from throughout the city, and they can help in different ways. They can help with your movement around the city itself. They can help with your contribution. They can make some cards wild or discard to make cards more powerful. So they're going to help you throughout the course of the game. They can also move the dragons around the city. So these dragons are ancient guardians of the city. And if you make a contribution in a space where a dragon is present, you're going to get a benefit for that. You're going to get a golden scale from that dragon. And what that is there's a certain amount of scale tokens in the game, depending on the number of players. And once those run out, we determine who has the most of them, and they get awarded a slew of crystals that they can use to later contribute to the Citadel. So very interesting game. We're really excited about this one. It was a classic of Dr. Reiner Knizia's several years ago, and we've given it the CMON treatment with all new miniatures and new art as well. So very excited about this one. As you said, it's just a prototype right now, but looking forward to the finished product for sure.
Well, I find it really interesting that these little dragon miniatures, at first I thought we were going to have to fight them, but yeah, they're actually beneficial. You want them on your space.
Yeah, absolutely. You'll see throughout the course of a game, you're actually making moves to either go to where the dragons are or to pull the dragons to where you are. You want to be around these dragons because the dragons are ancient guardians of the city, and they're going to be happy to see you working to rebuild it. So you get a benefit from it. So yeah, interesting twist.
So what exactly would my turn look like? What can I do on my turn?
Yeah. So on a turn, you can move, which is optional. So you can move two spaces orthogonally, and there are certain cards that can adjust those abilities. You can move further or jump to different places on the board. And then you can contribute, which is also optional. So if you end up on a spot, so for example, if I move two spaces to this spot here, I can contribute if I've got cards that equal 4 power or 3 power, I can contribute and put one of my contribution tokens down there. Now, I may have to overpay if I've got, for example, 2 3 tokens or 2 3 power cards, but I really want to get down on that 4. I can pay extra, I can overpay, and there's no change, but sometimes positioning is really important because whoever contributes the most is going to get a special benefit, and if there's a tie, the leftmost place is going to be the stronger one in that case. So then after you have contributed or not, and you can contribute actually as many times as you want to, as you're able to afford to, after your contribution, you're going to do a refresh phase where you're able to discard as many cards as you want, and then you will draw up two more than the amount of cards you discarded, which means if you discard nothing, you'll draw two cards, and if you discard three cards, you'll pick up five. So you'll always have like a good sort of flow of cards coming into your hand, and if you have a hand that's really not working for you, you can dump it all, get new ones, and have the ability to have a powerful turn the next round.
Yeah, I really like that because some games you can kind of get stuck with what you've drawn and there's not a way to cycle those cards. Yeah. Well, how many people does this play? What's the player count and about how long does a game take?
So it's 2 to 4 players, and it takes about an hour to play. And it's a good game in the sense that there is a lot of lead changes and swings throughout the game, so it's really hard to determine the winner until the end result.
All right. Well, thank you for sharing Blue Moon City with us, and you can look forward to hearing more information about it as the year goes on.